Hi everybody, my name is Annalisa Carvalho and I study Physics Engineering at Instituto Superior Técnico. I am currently working on my master thesis in Particle Physics at LIP. Today, I want to tell you about my master project, but more importantly, I want to let you know why Particle Physics is interesting, important and worth studying. So, let's start from the beginning. In the beginning, the universe was extremely compact. Everything that existed was packed very close together, and the temperature was so high that the fundamental particles moved freely at extremely high energies. But then, the universe started to expand. And as it expanded, it got cooler. And as it got cooler, the energy of the particles decreased, allowing for the formation of more complex structures, like atoms, molecules, and ultimately everything we know. Today, inside particle colliders, we try to recreate the starting conditions of the universe. To achieve this, we accelerate particles, providing them with enough energy so that when they collide, they disintegrate, producing exciting new particles that we can detect and study. This is why facilities like the LHC located at CERN in Geneva were built. Here we collide protons, which are hydrogen nuclei. They achieve a maximum energy that corresponds to the energy of the universe itself when it was only 10 to the minus 10 seconds old. However, we still want to go further. We want to keep increasing the energy to have access to even earlier ages in the history of the universe. And this is why larger, more powerful accelerators are currently being designed. One of these projects is the Future Circular Collider. It is expected to be very similar to the LHC, but capable of achieving collision energies 10 times larger. To move forward, I need to tell you about the standard model of particle physics. It describes fundamental particles, their properties, and the way they interact with each other. We can divide the fundamental particles into groups, force carriers and matter particles. Force carriers, also called Gauge bosons, are the particles associated with the fundamental interactions: strong, electromagnetic, and weak. Each force can be interpreted as the exchange of the corresponding Gauge boson, the gluon, the photon, and the W and Z bosons. Matter particles are the constituents of all the matter in our world. They are the quarks and the leptons. Quarks are the particles that compose atomic nuclei, and there are six of them: up, down, charm, strange, bottom and top. There are three charged leptons: the electron, that orbits atomic nuclei forming atoms, and its two heavier siblings, the muon and the tau. Finally, there are three neutral leptons, the neutrinos. In addition to this, the theoretical formulation of the standard model rests on the existence of a very special particle, the Higgs boson. Its existence was predicted in 1964 by Peter Higgs, François Englert and Robert Brout. The underlying mechanism establishes that fundamental particles get their mass through the interactions they establish with the Higgs boson. In 2012 at the LHC, the Higgs boson was finally discovered, and the importance of the underlying mechanism was recognized with a Nobel Prize in Physics in 2013. The Higgs boson is considered to be the final piece of the standard model. However, the hard work is far from being over. On the one hand, its properties must be precisely measured. On the other hand, we know that the standard model is not the final theory of particle physics. It doesn't provide, for example, a description of gravity. Therefore, we need to explore other models. My project consists of studying the simultaneous production of two Higgs bosons and their subsequent decay to pairs of bottom quarks in the framework of the Future Circular Collider. This process allows us to measure the strength of the Higgs interaction with itself, which sheds light on the Higgs-Englert-Brout mechanism. It is also sensitive to the existence of new particles, which makes it suitable to probe physics beyond the standard model. The hard part of our job is isolating the process in which two protons collide and produce two Higgs bosons that then decay, producing four weak quarks. This is what we call the signal. And that is because there are other processes that can happen simultaneously that directly produce four weak quarks. This is what we call the background. For our detector, both processes look the same, but we only want to study one of them, the signal. Therefore, the biggest challenge is analyzing the information that comes out of the detector and trying to find ways to distinguish between the signal and the background. As you can see, there is a lot of work that still has to be done. If you wish to know more about particle physics, LIP, or physics engineering here at AIST, check out these links or send me an email. Thank you. Bye.